my God, something's wrong.
Facebook says we're live.
Oh, we are live. We're just experiencing technical difficulties. Hello, folks. We will be starting momentarily.
No music tonight?
Here it is. Totally sharing the wrong thing, everybody.
You didn't even get my swivel. It was perfect.
I didn't get the swivel. I shared the wrong screen. It's like basically everybody got to look at my Facebook and all the multitude of friends I don't have. Now it's exposed.
Do you have a boot camp hangover or what's going on?
No, I think it was technical difficulties unassociated with boot camp.
Unassociated. Okay. That's all good. Yeah, my screen's weird over here too.
Yeah, let's take a look at the chat, make sure. We're in play to music. Yeah, you know what? We started with Be Live, folks. We moved over to Zoom. It may be a new platform in the future. We may just create one.
Matt Forbes says we're not on split screen, so.
Right, because Matt, I was trying to hog all of the attention, but thanks for pointing it out to Scott.
You are a little bit of an attention hog. How is everyone?
Hey, everybody.
We got some viewers. We got Kenyon Zitska. We got Jim. We got Lisa. We got Larry. We got Barbara.
This is great. We're back.
Nicole, we hope you're feeling better. Andrea Johnson is watching. She's killing it. We got a following.
Nice. Hey, Scott, it was great seeing you in boot camp, by the way, in person. Did anybody see the new photo that Scott cropped? My wife took the photo, and Scott's wife cropped it out nice, and between the two of them, they made us look good.
Yeah, I really like that.
No easy task.
Did you see the banter back and forth today about the photo?
No, tell me about it. Tell me about the banter.
Well, Aaron, Bearland Aaron, said that... It looked like we were in a fight because of the whole round table thing where Mark was taken aback by my presence. He thought you might be jealous. So it looks like we're kind of.
Mark did show a favorite. Yes, that was exposed. Personally, I'm okay with it because you're a great guy.
You're secure. I love that.
Yes, I'm secure in my land investing.
Yes. So tonight we're going to do a few things, right?
Okay. What are we going to do?
We're going to do a boot camp review.
All right.
We're going to have a little segment called Micro to Macro.
The micro to the macro. I love that.
Yeah. And we may have a special guest.
Oh, okay.
But we'll see. Not sure.
Well, so what's your choice of drink for this evening?
I'm consistent with my drinks lately. I'm having a Maker's Mark again.
Maker's Mark. Tonight, I brought a special guest. His name is George Clooney, and he's in the form of a Casamigos Mezcal.
That is very interesting to me. You're very into this George Clooney thing lately.
No, my wife is, and I support her.
I think you have a little bit of a George Clooney crush.
I have a George Clooney liquor crush.
Yeah, I got you.
He makes good tequila, and there's nothing around it. And Maker's Mark, you are solid. You are consistent and nice.
It's a good bourbon. I like it. So well, I have to say, it was also very good to see you this last weekend at boot camp in Orlando. We're already looking forward to the next one, the next boot camp.
Which is going to be in San Antonio, Texas. Laura and I think that's one of the most excellent boot camp locations we have. We just love it. It's just a phenomenal. We love a drive across Texas. We fantasize about just buying 40 acres down there, reinventing our family. It's just so beautiful. People are friendly.
And you know what? This time boot camp is going to be on the Riverwalk.
Yes, it is. It's going to be on, is it called the Riverwalk? What's this called?
Well, it's called, we're at the Westin. The Westin is where we're having the boot camp. But it's right on the Riverwalk. And the Riverwalk.
You're right. And that's beautiful because that's, everybody goes to boot camp, so I'm fond of the different hats. There's a very excellent, that's not even good, those are two words that shouldn't go together, very excellent, but there's a very excellent hat shop there that's old as dirt. And if you go there looking for a cowboy hat like I did, you'll end up with another cap. It's amazing, that store. So I am looking forward to that. And that's going to come very quickly. And everybody, if you want to go, if you think you want to go, contact support, contact Danielle now, because these boot camps do sell out. I think there is at least probably 10, 15 people that weren't able to attend Florida just because we didn't have the space. So
get very in. True. Wow. I mean, these things are getting popular. The room fills up fast. So, I mean, even more importantly, in order to go to boot camp, we got to get the toolkit. You got to get the toolkit in your hands.
So how do I go to boot camp, Scott? I want to be at boot camp. I'm just coming to the Facebook group. I'm meeting you guys and your incredible robes and with your great banter. But I want to see you in person. I want to learn from Mark, Scott, Tate, Mimi, Eric. I want to learn from everybody. Even see Danielle because it's Texas. How do I do it?
Here's the great news. You get two free tickets to boot camp when you purchase the Investor Toolkit. Now, the Investor Toolkit, we've said this for the last few weeks. It was just re-released. Danielle Dybal put her heart and soul and mind into this thing for months. It is an amazing interface, and you learn all things land investing in the Investor Toolkit. That's what I started with 3 years ago. I started doing deals with it. So I did a deal with it. I got a free ticket to boot camp. I went to boot camp in Vegas. I met Mark Podolsky. I met Scott Todd. I met a lot of people who had changed their lives, and that was my, it hooked me. Hook, line, and sinker. I was in after that weekend. I knew this was something special.
You know, what's great is that people that typically come to us, people in our community, they're successful in their own right, right? They have their own careers, their own life experience. They're very successful. They're just looking for something different. They're looking to shrink down the amount of time they spend in creating income. Passive income in our case, right? So for those of you know or don't know, we teach two things, land investing, but the niche within the niche that I always talk about is how not to land invest, meaning how do you build a team, systems, automation, delegation, or as Mark was pointing out this past weekend, elimination, right? How do you do this and change that Scott and I always talk about? How do you make and go from 20 to 40 hours and create the same income in 2 to 4 hours? We call it what, Scott?
20 to 40 to 2 to 4.
What are we dropping?
We're dropping the zero.
Dropping the zero. You complete me.
The zero.
Segment complete.
I have completed you there.
We'll have a sip to that.
But I like the 20 to 40 to 2 to 4. It's like that Chicago song.
You're the meaning in my life?
25 or 64.
Oh, I didn't. Is a Chicago song about this?
Yeah, Chicago sings 25 or 6 to 4. Larry Overstreet, if you're watching, can you tell me the origin of that song? Because it's always bothered me. You're probably a Chicago guy. Larry Overstreet's watching. You know, he posted an amazing picture yesterday. I don't know if you saw this, Mike. We talk about these pictures. Like sometimes we post these pictures. They're called land investing pictures of the day. Be on the lookout for more of them. The community, be on the lookout because we're going to be posting some of these. But anyway, Larry, he had a picture yesterday of an open road at sunset, and he said, "My office today."
Ah, that's awesome.
You know what? Awesome.
Yes, you know what's equally awesome is KJ's comment: "Best whiskey for land investors." You're gonna love this, Scott. Maker's Mark Podolsky.
That's exactly why I drink it. There you go.
Yeah, I know.
That's awesome, man. Thank you.
George Clooney isn't actually the epitome of land investing. I get it.
I bet George Clooney owns some land.
I bet he does.
I bet he doesn't sell it on land contract, but I bet he owns some land.
Very possible. Very possible. Scott, tell me, was there a memorable moment from this past boot camp? I mean, every boot camp has memorable moments, but Any memorable moments for you from this past boot camp?
So, I mean, I would have to say that it's not necessarily a memorable moment. I just really, really enjoyed my interaction with everyone throughout the day during the happy hours. We had two great happy hours, which I thought was amazing.
Yes.
Gave us a lot of time to talk to people and connect. And you know what? It just, it's really cool because as the weekend progresses, you see the excitement in people's eyes just get more and more and more exuberant. How's that for a word?
I was like, waiting for you to go because it almost seemed like there wouldn't be a word that would fit into the end of that, but you pulled it off.
Thank you. I appreciate it. It just, like, you see the fire in their eyes, right? Like, the first day, and there was even a woman in the room, Marge, I think, was giving Mark a hard time. Like, the one reason she came for the weekend was because she wanted to make sure that Mark was actually a real figure, and this was a real business. So,
right.
So people come in, they might be a little bit nervous, they might be a little bit, you know, treading lightly, wondering if this is a real thing. By the end of the first day, they realize this is a real thing. By the end of the second day, they realize, oh my gosh, look at what all these people are doing with this business in just a few short months or even a few short years, and I could do this. And they get this fire in their eyes, and this, they're just motivated to move forward. I love seeing that, because that transition occurs, it seems, every boot camp. They're a little trepidatious the first day, and the second day they're like, oh my gosh, this is phenomenal. I love that.
Yeah, I agree. You know, one thing I really enjoyed about this boot camp is that you realize, and a few people, because Mark pulled a few people out of the audience and brought them up, and there are a lot of people just basically, I'll call them sleepers, right? They're crushing the business, but they just like to remain kind of quiet and doing their own thing. And we don't talk about it a lot. They just, you know, they just don't want to expose their lives to Facebook and to a podcast. But there's people that learned from Mark that are crushing the business quietly, making sales left and right, and totally changing their lives. So they're there. And that's what's great when you go to the boot camp. You're going to meet people of all different levels and all different, you know, levels of experience, that is. And, you know, you got a guy next to you that could be selling parcel of land one day, another one the next day, and keep going, right? And you don't, and you're sitting right next to them. And you know, you just have such opportunity to mingle with people that are successful. And it's awesome. It's just a great community. It truly is. And I can't say it enough. These boot camps are phenomenal. And you've got to come to San Antonio. If you're anywhere near within striking distance of San Antonio, you'd be crazy not to go. It's an awesome time.
Yeah. And you know what? Another thing that really became apparent to me this weekend is, you know, this was Mark Podolsky's 16th boot camp. And it makes me really think about the impact that he has had on the lives of so many. I mean, boot camp used to be 25 people. Then it went to 50 people. Now, you know, Orlando was like 80 people. We had 100 people last January last August in Scottsdale. Think of the hundreds of people that this man has had an impact on. It's really phenomenal. I don't know. It's really humbling for me. I'm thankful for him. He does so much for so many people, and you or I would not be here without him. And I think that's really, I think some of us, you lose sight of that sometimes. But I think we really have so much to owe Mark, and he's so genuine, and he brings his best to these things. This is the 16th time he's done this, and he approaches every single boot camp with so much enthusiasm and energy and genuineness. It really motivates me to be better.
It's true. He puts his heart and soul into this. And, you know, I know he's exhausted at the end because he leaves nothing on the table, right? He just goes right at it. And it's really amazing. And it's just everybody there gets something out of him. And no matter, I always say, no matter where you are in this land and business, you'll come away with something from that boot camp. I know I do. I know you do, Scott. We talk about this all the time. So it's actually just incredible. So make sure you're there, right? And if you, not sure about what we're talking about when we say toolkit and flight school, because there are people out there, believe it or not, that may not have any idea what we're talking about. You can schedule a call with us, Mark. Scott, what's the, is it the landgeek.com/training? There's a couple of call links. Anytime you want to talk to us, one thing we make sure that we are is available, right? If you want to have a call, talk to us one-on-one, you're more than welcome to do that. You want to talk to us both at the same time, just make the request. We're very easy to schedule that with.
We can do that. We spend a lot of time together. I mean, our wives, you know, they're not happy about it, but so we'll talk to you. I'm kidding. I'm totally kidding.
I know. And there's the link. You put it in there.
Put it in
there. Awesome. So should we do a segment? What should we do? I mean, you know, we can just talk all day long because that's what we do anyway. And now we make everybody listen to it. But should we do a segment?
Well, yeah, I think we got a couple segments we can do. So I got to minimize my screen here a little bit. Let's see. Okay, there we go. So I think we should do a Facebook quote of the week. And I'm just going to reach out here to a Land Geek review from the weekend, since we're in bootcamp mode, right? We get, you know, we get a lot of positive feedback from these events, and it's really cool to see how much these events have an impact on people.
Go ahead.
Oh, you know what, Mark, fill the time here a minute, because I'm gonna find that video of Evan.
That's fine. I was just gonna tell you a lot of chatter about not having the robes at boot camp. We promised to correct that for the next boot camp. So I think we'll just wear them during the social hour. You know, they are comfortable, and so yeah, a little bit of chatter there, and people are asking us to sing. Lisa, thank you. I'm assuming you loved our singing at boot camp if you're requesting it now. that wasn't planned, but when Mark Podolsky tells you to sing, you sing long and you sing until he tells you to stop. I mean, that's just the way it goes.
That's exactly right. Yes.
Doesn't matter if you're in front of a room of 60 people and you're totally nervous, you just sing.
Mark, Mike, I'm going to share my screen with you here because I want everybody to see this video. Huh?
Please do. I want to have a sip of my mezcal.
All right. Sounds good.
Bit smoky, by the way.
All right. You ready?
Yeah.
See that okay?
You're playing a movie?
This is from Evan. And Chloe, is it?
Okay.
They were at boot camp this weekend. They're a young couple. Evan is a professor.
The whole screen showing, you know, by the way. It's all right. We're all going to see you. Hold that up. Just hit the green button so we can see it nice and loud.
There. How's that? Okay.
No,
all right. Here we go.
Okay. Yep.
Can you hear that?
No.
Hold on.
Oh, boy. All right. I'm gonna fill the void with some not singing, but
quit mocking me.
No, I'm not mocking you. And we have a little segment coming after this. It's gonna be called the micro to macro. So stay tuned for that. So just because we're having technical difficulties going away, because we got something in store for you folks that's gonna be very helpful.
Hold on.
Called the micro to macro.
All right, ready now?
Damn. You got a lot of things playing right now.
Where'd it go? There it is. There it is. All right, ready? Here we go.
Yep. There it is.
Hey, guys. Thanks for an awesome weekend at Land Geek Boot Camp. We had a great time.
We can't wait to start flight school in November, and we hope to see you guys in Las Vegas at the April Boot Camp.
It's really inspiring, and we've actually made it our personal goal to be featured on your Art of Passive Income podcast within the next 2 years.
Awesome.
Thanks again for a really inspiring weekend in Orlando.
See you guys soon.
See ya.
What do you think of that, huh?
Very cool. Is that on Facebook?
No, they sent that to me, actually. Awesome. We have dubbed them.
For any guy who doesn't know what dub is, you probably received one from Scott and I. We love the fact, and you could use this in your land business as well. You can send a clickable link with a video message. You know, everybody knows speech to text can be pretty
powerful.
You have a non-accent like myself, and I try to speech to text and it comes up with some wacky words. So I just send video now. So if anybody would like one, just reach out to me and let me know, and I'll send you a video message with that service dub, and you can check it out. It's pretty cool. You can email it, you can text it, hyperlink, whatever.
Yeah, I really enjoy using Dub, especially with people who've been to boot camp. But anyway, yeah, so they sent that. So just to give you a little background, Evan got the toolkit a couple months ago, came to boot camp. He's all in with this. He saw the power of it. He and his girlfriend, Chloe, I believe, are going into this. And here's the other exciting thing. When are they starting flight school? They're starting flight school during our first ever Saturday flight school on November 10th at 9 a.m. Eastern.
Yeah, that's our first Saturday class. It's going to be a great one. And, I like what Barbara Thibodeau put here. I love they know it's a marathon and not a sprint. It takes time. Exactly. And one of my favorite quotes is, it is a marathon, but the only difference is at the end of that marathon, each mile is going to be faster than your first mile. So that's unlike a traditional marathon. Well, I don't know. I'm not a marathon runner. Maybe I could be full of it right now. I don't know. They don't typically run their last miles faster than the first miles, do they, Scott, in a real marathon?
I don't think so. Maybe at the Boston Marathon.
At the Boston one, maybe. So in this land investing, because what you're doing is you're building the systems, the automation, the delegation, elimination. So actually those last miles are quicker than your first mile. So yeah, it's definitely a marathon. We don't call this a get rich quick process. This is a build wealth steadily over time. It's real. It works. You just have to learn the process and commit to it. How's your cup? You a little empty?
I'm actually okay, but you can pull the big guy up.
Pulling the big guy up because it's time.
Matt Forbes, much taller in person. There he is.
There he is.
Gentlemen.
Look like you were pontificating.
I literally was buying airline tickets to San Antonio.
Awesome. See? Yeah.
Massive action right there.
And unlike this past boot camp where I got a text on Saturday that said, your flight is 10 minutes delayed. And I'm like, why would Southwest know my flight's 10 minutes delayed for tomorrow? So I'd actually booked the tickets going home for my wife and I for Saturday. I'm so smart and I pay attention to details. So I was like double checking that I actually did it right this time, which I did. So
don't look at me
like that, Bosman. Don't look at me like that. Grab your maker's mark. Let's go. Zano, raise a glass. Come on.
Mezcal.
To everybody who's at boot camp and everybody who wasn't, have a cocktail. You deserve it.
Thanks, Matt.
Thanks, Matt. Hey, Matt. Second boot camp, right?
Yeah, that was my second boot camp.
All right. So what was your takeaway from the weekend? Biggest takeaway.
We didn't talk about me talking about that. Biggest takeaway out of this, it's totally doable. I learned a ton. Don't get me wrong. I was in the VIP room because I'm in coaching now. But, I went to flight school and I'm like, I know this works because I've done other real estate stuff in the past. And I'm like, mailing works. I understand all these things. And flight school got me going. But I really walked out of there and I'm like, yep, I'm 100% going to be one of these guys that in 6 months is at 2, 3, 4K. And in 12 months is at, 5, 6, 7, 8K. And in 3 years is you, wearing a funny robe on a Thursday night, drinking whiskey at 2 a.m. Without a real job. Right. So I came out of there fully believing that that's the case, where I think I went in going like, hey, I hope I can get there. My wife and I kind of looked at each other. We're like, yeah, this is it. We just got to do this. So that was really good. And the VIP room is crazy. No one really had prepared me for that. Oh yeah. That is some next level stuff. What I learned from everybody in that room is really crazy. So it was great. It was really good.
There are some masterminds in that room.
Yeah. Yeah. I assumed it was sort of like Tate and Scott, sort of like running the show. There's some guys in there that do a lot of land sales. They know a lot of tricks. And what was really cool is they're like, oh, hey, this is what you're doing. Yeah, like, hey, try this. And I'm like, really? This is, we'd be competing. And they're like, oh, it doesn't matter. We don't care at all. And they're so free with the information.
Abundance mentality.
Yeah, it's really unique. We're competitors, right? We should be duking it out. And instead, they're bending over backwards to help me with my problems. So it's cool. It was really cool.
Yeah. There are a couple of people in that room that blow my mind. I mean,
yeah,
I think it must be a phenomenal experience in that room. And, you know, that's just something that, that people who go to boot camp, I think they also get pumped up for is knowing that they have the possibility of being in that VIP room in the future, because they talk to you at happy hour and they're like, wow, that must be amazing. You know, and I love that, that abundance mentality. I love that, the fact that you guys are all in that room helping each other forward, to get to the point where we're reaching these goals. I think it's amazing.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. They don't really, nobody prepares you for the VIP room. I felt, you know, and my wife, Anne, was like, well, what's it going to be like? Cause she came to Vegas and, you know, she was the most skeptical person ever on the planet of all time. And she came out of Vegas out of the regular, you know, boot camp going, this could work. That guy's, he's real. He's not nearly as fake as I just assumed he would be. But she came out of this one and was like, oh yeah, this is it, right? This is everything we want. I mean, our minds are completely changed around. So shout out to Barbara Thibodeau. I got to throw it out there. Barbara, if you're going to San Antonio, yeah, we're going to hang out. We'll have dinner. It'll be great.
Nice.
I'm really excited. It'll be fun.
And we got some shout outs for the snowball ice cube. Is that what you have, Matt?
Yeah. My wife bought these for me.
Are we getting a nor'easter Saturday night? Is that what's happening?
Dude, I'm supposed to take 72 Cub Scouts camping this weekend. And I, right. I'm rolling from a full week of travel, overnight, red eye into boot camp, back to work for the full week. And then I was supposed to go on a camp out. And I'm like, I stand up in front of this room. I got a, you know, 130 Cub Scout parents and Cub Scouts. And I'm like, so here's the deal. As much as I want to spend the entire weekend with you in a tiny little cabin, instead, we're just going to stay home and watch movies. So Cub Scout meeting canceled, nor'easter, supposed to get 4 inches of rain. Zano, you're going to be, you know, you'll be called into work. It'll be great.
I'm already working that day. Yeah, it's going to be fun.
Look at that. I'm already. What's up? Just my day job. Just save lives. It's cool. No big deal. I'm a hero. Whatever. It's what I do.
It's what I do. It's awesome.
Drink more. Can we get a Mike Zano word of the day? Can we get it roll right into that segment?
That's a good segment.
You know what? That's a wonderful idea. I wish you had
that segment.
I wish you had the cue cards.
I feel like I let you down the last few times.
Oh, the Laga.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot my sign.
For those who've never seen this show before, which can't be very many people at all, this is what we call the Boston Laga segment.
Boston Laga.
Here's my favorite Boston word.
Cheetah. Don't play cards with a cheetah.
The cheetah.
The cheetah. So Mike, this is where we're going to mix it up a little bit tonight. Instead of spelling a word.
Like Pictionary?
Well, no, we're just going to do kind of how to speak Boston, right? So not only is there the linguistic challenge.
big words late at night with Scotch. I don't know.
Yeah, right? I am doing okay.
Scott always makes repeat myself on Vox. He's like, yeah, Mike, could you repeat that one more time, please?
I could not understand that, Mike. Now, the difference between Mike and I, when he listens to my Voxer, he can put it on 3x speed and understand what I'm saying.
Absolutely.
I have to put his on like half speed.
Yeah. Yeah. Does Voxer translate to text? Have they figured that out yet?
No.
That might be helpful.
So, what's your name? Mike. How to speak Boston.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Here in the Midwest, we say dinner. Dinner.
Huh? Dinner?
Here in the Midwest, we say... let's go out for dinner.
Dinner.
What do you say?
Dinner.
Nope. No, pretend you're from Rhode Island.
Oh, supper?
There it is.
Yes.
We're going to have to translate the New England terms because they're not all generic. Yeah, but in Rhode Island, we have supper.
How do you spell that, Matt?
F-O-O-D.
Never had to spell that word.
S-U-P-A-H.
S-U-P-A-H.
S-U-P-P-A-H, SUPPA. SUPPA.
SUPPA. Yeah. SUPPA.
There it is.
Yep.
We only got about 15 more of those to go. I'm excited.
Yeah, good.
15 more suppers?
No, 15 more words to share in the future.
We found a really funny Facebook post. And I was like, oh, this is perfect. Zane will screw up all of these words. This is great. So I sent it to Scott earlier today. Perfect.
All right.
That's it?
What's next? That's it. Suppa.
Oh, all right. I thought we'd do it a whole bunch. All right, listen. It's time for macro to micro. Let's talk about it.
Micro to macro.
Oh, yeah. All right, this is the way that...
you don't want to go macro to micro. That's not the way you want to go.
All right, well, I'm going to give you a visualization, okay? You're in your room.
Room.
In your house, and you look outside the window. Okay?
Micro.
You're outside of your house, and you're looking in through the windows inside your house.
Macro.
So this is how it works. You have to work on your... so far, you're going to work on your system, right? And sometimes, like right now, I'm in my house. I'm working in the business here, working on my systems, right? I'm working on it, but I'm in here tinkering around. But every so often, you have to step outside the house and then just watch the process work. But it doesn't work on its own. You need to induce something. You have to inject something into it. What is that? To see how it all flows. What is it? I'm going to grab my sign.
Deal flow?
Right. How do you get deal flow? So you do a massive amount of mailings and you watch the system, and then all of a sudden something kinks up, something stops, something gets clogged, right? So you got to come back in that house and you got to tinker and fix it. Then you go back out and you test it again.
Yeah.
What? This is so true, though. This is so true. And then you watch, and then something else catches up, and you go back in and fix it. This is a process as an entrepreneur in our business where you're in the business, out of the business, you're going in and out, but each time you're getting it smoother and smoother, and then you're going to be able to move that deal flow further down the line until eventually one sweet little deal, like it's got, oh, wow, wrong analogy, but it makes its way from one side all the way to the other, right? And nice and smoothly passes through with no clogs. Right? Then your machine has really started to work.
Yeah. So the hard part of this business is constructing that machine. Right?
Yes.
Here's the other hard part, though. Stepping away from the machine.
Mm.
Right? So we got the micro and we got the macro. So there are all these things when you start out, right, that you're working in the business, you're working in this micro environment. So Mike, like you're going to complete me here. Okay. And
as always,
and I'm going to name something that occurs in the early stage of this business. And you're going to flip that to how it looks in the later stages of the business. Does that make sense?
Yes. And then we're going to do a little Pictionary. I got something for you.
All right. Sounds good. So.
I'm uncomfortable. I need an adult.
Here's the first thing. Microenvironment.
Yes.
You're creating a machine. You're doing it yourself. Scrubbing a list.
Mm. Yeah.
Take that to the macro for me.
Right. That's great in its initial stages. Macros, you have someone like today, my person who's in charge of that process called me up. Hey, ready for another mailer? Yes. It's already gone. It's done. It's gone.
That's it. Wait. So.
Yeah, I didn't follow that.
So you're telling me that a process that you performed early in the business that took you hours to compile how many names for mailing?
Took one Voxer.
What's that?
It took one Voxer and it's done.
So how many names are we talking? Like how many mailings are we talking?
Well, this round I wanted to throw a big one out. So we're looking at 2,000.
Whoa.
So for 2,000 mailings, you sent a Vox to somebody that said, we need 2,000 names.
Yes, send the mailers.
Send the mailers.
That reminds me of a movie. What is that? Send the mailers.
Star Trek?
I'm not sure, but that's all it takes. When you have a pro, I put my team on Voxer. I love to communicate via Voxer with my team. So it's like, hey, how's it going? Good. Send the mailers.
Right. That's but it. But let's dive in though, right? I mean, it's not like you're like, you know, boop, send the mailers and they're going to go out and find the people and find the
county. He's already done the county research. That means right. He's going to, we have meetings, right? So you're right. Good point, Matt. So basically what happens is he'll do some county research for me. Say I want to look into a new area. I want to dive into another part of an area that I'm in. Do the research, right? Does the research. Gets all the kind of, just a basic, we have a quick meeting and he says, okay, Mike, this is what I'm thinking. And I go, yeah, it looks good. And then what happens after that? He says, okay, I'll get the stuff ready. And then you let me know when you want to mail. And I say, mail. And it goes up, boom, done, gone. So it's actually, yeah, this is a process of working with someone. This is the land business. It's about building an A team. You need A players. You get an A player that understands through working together, building a relationship back and forth. Of course, it wasn't always this quick, right? But we got it to this point where we know what has to happen. So with a Voxer, we can truly send out a mass amount of mailings because we've worked together. We've built this model.
So, I mean, think of the power of that. So you're taking taking county research, which you spent hours on in the beginning of this business, and you're taking scrubbing a list and compiling a list of 2,000 names, mm-hmm. which you spent how many hours on in the beginning of this business, and you broke that down to two voice messages on Voxer. We right. need county research. Mm-hmm. We need a good county that we can mail 2,000 people to.
Right.
They go do the work. There you go.
Yeah, done.
That's amazing, dude.
Right. And that's just going to feed into the next plate.
Well, yeah.
This is exactly what Scott Todd talks about, because that's the first plate, right? That is going to feed directly into plate number two, which is going to lead to three, and then four, and then five. It's all these plates, in my mind, Scott Todd, what he talks about, these plates, they turn into gears. One feeds the other, and that's the system. When you're looking outside the house, you're looking in, you're looking at all the gears, but sometimes they clog up, and you got to go in, and you got to tinker and get, you know, hey, okay, maybe there's something I need to fix here, but you know what? Each time you do it, you get better at it. You know, it's continually rinse, repeat, make it better every time.
Doing my refill now. You ready for the next one?
Ready.
Here's the next one. Microenvironment. Matt Forbes, you're doing due diligence on a property today. You're going to the assessor website. You are going to wherever. The assessor website, the treasurer.
You're everywhere.
Calling the recorder.
This is Matt's chance to complete you.
You're getting copies of prior deeds, right? Mike, take me to the macro environment.
Oh, macro environment, and anybody who's dealing with Mark can work with the Land Geek. So in terms of actually acquiring a due diligence on a property, it's like this, 24 hours, it's done. You don't have to make all these phone calls. You don't have to go gather all this data. You don't have to plug photos into a Dropbox folder. It is done for you in 24 hours.
You send the Land Geek VAs a parcel number, and in 24 to 48 hours, you get a very thorough due diligence report.
Magic.
It is magic.
It's magic. Right.
It's something I spent hours on early in the business. It's something I hated. It is not difficult, but
tedious.
That was in the micro environment. Now we're in the macro environment. It takes a minute to get online, to fill out the form. There you go.
Yeah. And go back to mailing, right? So Zeno, right? Like, you've been doing this forever, so you know what you're doing. You've built that team. So there's a woman in Facebook, Brenda, and I can't pronounce her last name, who is
Muhlenberg.
Yeah. Okay. Right. So Scott, you chimed in on this too. She goes, I was debating using Dropbox and Lob for LDPass, or, you know, or am I going to go like basically mail these things myself, or am I going to do this? And it was one person after another who was like, what are you doing? Just go get it done. And so, you know, you're talking about the human capital side of doing all this, but there's the automation side too.
Well, right? They're leveraged into our system. So what happens is this is the way I look at it, honestly, Matt. Like, you could go buy a whole bunch of mechanics tools, but it doesn't make you a mechanic, right? The tools leverage you. You have to have a combination of human element and these systems, this automation. So LG Pass with the power of Lob. Now, if you want to go into LG Pass, upload your list, and then have Dropbox and lick and stick and give them a kiss and push them in the mail because you feel the good luck of it, then go ahead and do it. But the reality is it's a combination of both, right? There's a human element, and then there's the automation element. But if you just had the automation and no understanding of what we're doing, then that ship's not sailing. So you have to understand, like I said, mechanics tools doesn't make you mechanic. I mean, you got the best tools, but a good mechanic's going to be work those tools like magic, right? Fix the car in a snap. So it's the same thing. LG Pass is like the high level tools for our business, but you got to have someone that's trained to utilize them, right? And the way they're trained is to, and that could be you or a person on your team, but they have to have a deep understanding, or you have to impart upon them a deep understanding of how our business works, how the machine moves forward, how the deal flow machine moves forward. Now, they don't have to understand every part of it. They have to understand their part of it, right? Their particular part, their plate, they have to understand. So it's two components, right? Whether you're mailing them or not, I mean, you could still hand mail up that. Nothing against it. I know some people really like to physically touch that mail and stick them in the mailboxes and all that kind of stuff. You know, you still got to get a list to LG Pass because that's going to create that flow process to make your deed and all that. But it's a combination, really. I don't even know if that's the answer.
No, I think it's close. It just, you know, as a new guy.
In other words, no, he says.
That's my play way of saying no. no, but as a new guy, right? Like, I don't have 10 VAs to go out and do this stuff. But what I can do very quickly is I can spend 10 minutes and I can still get 2,000 mailers out the door. I'm going to, but I could, right? So I can leverage some really easy automation in the beginning that saves me hours and hours and hours and hours and hours of time, right? I have yet to send my own letter. Like, I would never do that when I have Lob. I wouldn't do it.
So here's the thing, Matt. Like, you find a good VA. And even in the beginning, because maybe you're a little bit reluctant to give this up, but you do some really careful county research on your own, right? Takes what? Half hour? You train your VA that takes 15 minutes. You say, I need names in this county. And that VA gets you names in this county.
Agreed.
Name after name after name, thousands and thousands of names. They present to you a list. You price the list. You're still spending, what, 45 minutes to an hour on 1,000 to 2,000 mailers? That's macro compared to the beginning of all this.
Right. Yeah. And let's not take away the fact that to train somebody to do this or to work with someone to build the trust level takes time, but it's the highest and best use of your time to do that, because it can be frustrating teaching anybody, I don't care what it is, to do something that you already do very well, because it takes time to translate and transmit that information of how to and work with them and then trust them. But once that happens, that's it. You're out of that process, right? Yeah. But it takes time. It takes time to build the relationship and trust. Like, if you're going to invest a lot of money in a mailing campaign, you have to truly trust that person that you've worked with and developed a relationship and trained, and that they can actually fulfill that to a high level. So that takes time. So what we're talking about, a couple of Voxers, a couple of meetings, setting them up, but we're talking months of preparation for that, right? But that's the highest and best use of your time, because then you're done.
Yeah, exactly. So do you want to spend your time handwriting 200 letters, or do you want to spend your time sending out 800 to 1,000 mailers via Lob with our generic offer letter, which really doesn't provide any different result than a handwritten letter?
Right. Well, so the thing for the new people is, right, even if it wasn't quite as good, do you want to go spend 5 hours doing this? Or do you want to go spend 45 minutes doing this and 4 hours working on other parts of the business? Because if you're new, guess what? You don't have a lot of those 5 hour blocks. And so it's, where are you going to place your time? And LG Pass and Lob is an easy automation that buys you more free time to go work on the other stuff.
I have one thing to say.
Is that why the pen stuck to your finger?
That's confusing.
Yep.
Oh, yep. Is he here?
Oh.
Yep. Uh-oh.
Oh, he's not even there.
He's watching.
Oh.
Oh, look at that.
How do you know he's watching? You stalking him?
Eric Peterson is watching. He snuck in. He's sneaky. He's
yeah. quiet. He's a smart guy. Eric sat down with me for like what he thought was going to be about 10 minutes, and I think I grabbed him for like 40 in the VIP room. Not the dumbest guy.
Irascible.
Yeah.
We all learned new words. Irascible.
Yeah. It's great.
No, I mean, that's tough.
Eric, since you're just tuning in, we're talking about, well, we had a boot camp review, which was fun. Now we're talking about micro to macro. We're talking about those things in the business where you are heavily involved in the micro environment and how they transitioned into the macro environment.
Right. And how the best, I mean, especially like you just said, Matt, a lot of people come to this business and they are looking to build the model, but they only have a small amount of time. So I still say the highest and best use of their time is to build these systems, because once they get that down, they can start to scale.
Agreed. Yeah.
Agreed. So,
awesome. Macro to micro. We'll stop. In fact, Scott and I, we may actually on a future episode do a quick list scrub. We got some ideas we're working on to kind of inspire the community to show you how quick it can be done and how simple it is and how you don't overthink it. Oh, that's right. Pictionary, right? Ready? Here we go. This is a common problem most of you have in the beginning. Ready, Scott? Can you identify it?
That's what I was going to say. Analysis by over paralysis by over analysis. Right?
I don't even work here, and I know what that looks like.
No,
because I did it all afternoon as I was on cold calls trying to figure out county research.
You know that happens too. Is when you have so many look at this.
Forbes, you're making me look bad. Do you want the robe here, Matt?
While I really would appreciate your size extra small men's tiny boy robe, Daddy needs a big boy robe. So.
Yeah. Here's the other thing I want to just kind of end of this little statement about it is that you could easily overwhelm yourself in this business because you're going to start thinking about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things at a time, and then your mind's going to reel back and forth. Just pick one thing, think about it, develop a way to actually begin to, how can you automate that? How can you map it out? And look who's up and saying, what's up, Matt Forbes? You guys just catch that?
Look at that. Big dog.
Make his mock Podolsky.
You know what Mark is really good at that you guys never talk about? The dude gives a good bear hug, right? So, it's impressive. It was good. Like, it was a full wraparound. It was nice.
He's a hugger.
He's a hugger. That's going to be the word for next week. Hugger.
Hugger. Yeah. Did you see that, Mark? What Scott's drinking? You say it again, Scott, because I think he may have missed it.
It's the Make is Mock Podolsky.
We got a new whiskey. We can, or is that bourbon? What is that? Is that a whiskey?
It's bourbon.
Yeah. So the Podolsky bourbon, Make is Mock.
Mark, since you're on here live, I want to say go back to about minute 7 or 8 because I don't know. We were just talking about how much we appreciate you in all of this and how much you've changed so many lives. And here's to you, Mark.
Cheers.
Cheers.
And by the way, what is that you're drinking, Matt? I didn't catch that.
I had a really good land week, feeling really, really strong. So my liquor choices will tell you how I'm doing. Right. So this is my favorite. This is my favorite scotch, which is the Lafroig 10. Really, really peaty stuff. If you don't drink scotch, don't drink that. I'll drink it on your behalf, but
I got one. I'm gonna go to the local store tomorrow. I'm gonna probably end up sending you a picture of it. You let me know if I should get it. The guy told me it was kind of rare. I don't remember the name, but I'll show you the picture tomorrow. You let me know what you think.
Dude, I only live an hour from you. Why don't you go ahead and buy that? And if you don't like it, I'll pick it up.
Nice.
And Mark, I'm drinking a little mezcal because I'm feeling a little smoky.
Yes.
I will hide my laughter with my glass.
And I ran out of his regular liquor.
Hey, Mike, are there any other micro to macro examples you'd like to give before the night ends?
The whole idea, the whole business is macro, micro, micro, macro.
Micro, macro.
Is how to take something you're doing yourself and to outsource it through automation, delegation, or identify as Mark. I love that he pointed this out at boot camp right in the very beginning. Do I need to do this? Can I eliminate it? Right? A good thing that you can eliminate, right, is that you don't have to do due diligence. Get the landing VAs. You can just eliminate that. Be done with it. You don't have to go and hire someone to go to that. You already have people that are trained experts to do this. So Micro macro is our entire business model at all levels. And that's what makes us able to scale. That's how we go from we make in 20 to 40, well, whatever, 20, 40, 2, 4. Drop the
zero.
Drop the zero.
Hey, you know, I believe you came up with the M&Ms a few years ago, Mike, mailings and marketing.
No, the M&Ms are at the boot camp. Yeah, one time, you know.
Yeah, but there's more M&Ms, micro and macro.
I didn't get any M&Ms.
Macro, oh, more M&Ms.
More M&Ms, micro and macro.
M&Ms, look at the M&Ms is a candy that keeps giving.
M&Ms, mailings, marketing, and mentorship. Mentorship, seriously.
Escott out there is really liking your how do you even pronounce that that you're drinking?
Lafroig.
Escott's saying it's a favorite, so.
Yeah, that's good.
Can I say one thing real quick?
Yes. Alliteration?
Mailings, marketing, and mentorship? I love that alliteration.
Yeah, mailing, marketing, mentorship, micro, macro. And other words that also begin with today's letter, M. Right. Brought to you by the number 4. Thanks, everyone, for watching.
So here's the thing. There's so many people, Mike, you talk to and I talk to. They realize that they need to change something in their lives, right?
Right.
They know that they need to take massive action, yet they are very reluctant to bring in the mentor into their life. And what I would say to those people is have faith in this community, have faith in the leaders in this community, because you will move more quickly with mentorship.
Right. Right.
And that's one of the things at bootcamp this weekend that a couple of us were talking about. While there were a lot of people who were very interested in moving forward with mentorship, there were a lot of people who were very reluctant to move forward with mentorship. And I think that the reason they're reluctant is many reasons. But Mike, you are an example. I'm an example. Matt Forbes, you're an example. We have so many living and breathing examples and proof in this business that mentorship moves you more quickly, that you should really consider taking the leap sooner than what you feel you should.
Yeah, well, it's different levels too. I mean, the first mentorship in a very micro environment. Let's talk about micro, macro. We'll talk about the toolkit versus flight school, right? First, micro is the fact that, you know, micro mentoring is that you're taking this known model that works and you're studying it, but then it becomes an issue of execution, right? Because you're taking this, but you're deciphering it and you're getting into that paralysis by overanalysis, right? So then you go into the macro, you go into flight school, and then that's your big mentorship, your very first big mentorship. And you begin to see that by moving your feet, as Scott Todd says, and taking this business, you know, in a step-by-step manner and focusing on what you need to do, when you need to do it, that you can actually move forward and start buying land and then start selling land. And then the next big macro is coaching, because coaching is really about, okay, you're producing, but we need to scale you. We need to get you to the point where you can replace your income, reach your macro goal, right? And the best way to do that is to work with someone who has made all the mistakes that you are going to possibly make and walk you through those so you don't spend hours and days just kind of stressing it. So this micro macro is just kind of built into everything. And the return on that investment, the return on your not only monetary investment, your time, as you often like to say, Scott, time invested is huge, is absolutely astronomical. So, and I, Mark likes it. Did you see this? I want to reiterate for him because he was like, drop the zero. Is that a new catchphrase? Yeah. Mark, we're talking about, Scott and I always talk about how to make the same income that you'd make in 20 to 40 hours in 2 to 4 hours. So we call that
drop the zero.
Drop the zero. So it is a new catchphrase, and it's a pretty cool one, I think.
Dropping the zero.
Dropping it.
Yeah.
Mike dropping it hot.
I'll tell you, not because Eric Peterson's listening to the show, but you know, he went over some strategies to rephrase my ads, right? And even from, so we started posting at Bootcamp, of course, right? But I've talked to probably six people in the last 2-3 days off those ads. I talked to six people in the previous 30 days off my ads, right?
Was the word sexy in those ads?
No, we took sexy out. Sexy was gone. But yeah, it's back to the coaching thing, right? It's I don't know. I don't know if it's for everybody, but I tell you what, it's definitely for me.
Can you share the specifics? I think it's okay to share the specifics.
I'd have to ask the person who writes the ads, which is not me. That would be my evil wife.
My minion.
Look at Scott Anderson. Drop the zero, the new 10X.
Ooh.
Oh, I like that a lot.
I like that too. Grant Cardone would be jealous. I like it.
Mike Zano, that's your...
He's thinking about it.
That's your ebook right there, dude.
Yeah.
Well. Talk amongst yourselves for about 3 minutes, please.
In between my 11,000 mailings, I might be able to write my ebook. Oh, an evil mailing?
Evil.
The Diet Coke of evil? Not quite evil enough.
I like that a lot. Mini me, would you like a...
I seriously need you to keep talking amongst yourselves. I got a little surprise for you guys in a minute.
Really do it. So Scott, what are you doing later? It's okay.
Hey, Mike, we should probably close shop, though. It's been an hour.
Oh, yeah. Are we limited now?
No, but like, wow. Seriously, it's an hour. Well, I mean, Netflix limits our time to 59 minutes, so.
Oh, well, you guys don't want to lose your rankings as the world's greatest, most popular show of all time, so.
It's exactly right.
I'd be careful.
Listen, so I think tonight has been an incredible episode, if I had to say so myself. Anybody else want to?
I would very much agree. It was a great boot camp review. It was a great discussion about micro to macro. And yeah, love it.
So, who's going to be the next boot camp?
Who's going to be at the next boot camp?
I just bought my tickets. I'll be there.
So
I'm gonna book my hotel earlier than this one so I can stay in the actual.
Oh no, where were you? Were you not at the the residence or whatever that was?
The Renaissance.
Renaissance, no.
Boot camp sells out extremely quick, right? I mean, there's really no other way to look at it. You have to make the reservation now, right? You have to get in there because this one in San Antonio is absolutely going to sell out extremely quickly, right? So, by the way, guys, I just bought Drop the Zero. That's what I had to do. I was afraid somebody might buy that, so I had to go buy it. It's amazing. I
got dropthezero.com?
Yeah, we own it.
You bought it?
Of course. Massive action.
Yes. That's awesome.
Can you believe nobody owned that?
Nobody owns this Drop the Zero.
Oh, somebody does now. Lane Geek, guys.
That is awesome.
Sorry, sir. Matt, I'm sorry, but I, you know, when you said that and someone wrote Grant Cardone, I said, wait a minute.
Drop to zero.
I'm going to buy it.
But Lisa says somebody stayed at some Airbnbs.
Airbnbs are awesome. I think that's always a safe joke. But, you know, you want to be, if you can be in the same hotel as all of us, it's just easy.
So much better.
Right? It's so much better.
So, you know what happened is Saturday night is, so Ann and I left, had a couple cocktails at the function that was sort of spur of the moment, right? We were in the hotel. We were like, oh, we're going to dinner. We're like, oh, hey, Sarah Ann. Like, we hung out in Vegas. You want to go to dinner? We'll go to dinner. So the three of us are going to dinner, right? And, you know, we walk in and there's Handsome Rob, whose name I forget, but he was actually on one of Mark's podcasts. His name's not Rob at all. I refer to him as Handsome Rob because I could not remember his name. So Handsome Rob, if you're watching. So I saw him and I'm like, hey, you're a Land Geek guy. Like, you want to come to dinner? Like, we're here. And he's like, I'm sitting alone. Like, yeah, sure. I'm like, yeah, come on in. And then we had four. And then another guy walked in and he sat down. I'm like, dude, I think I saw you in a room or you're a homeless guy. Get on in here. Let's have dinner. Let's do this. And it was great. And then Zano showed up later and sat not anywhere near us. So that was nice.
I showed up later too, if you remember.
So I don't remember much at that point in the evening or at all, even. So.
Wow.
Well, what's the last segment? What do we have tonight?
Well, we got a toast. I think we got to have a toast. And I don't know. I think we need to toast. I don't know if we've done this before. I think we need to toast to the man, Mark Podolsky.
Let's toast to Mark.
Here's to Mark. Make his Mark Podolsky.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark.
For all that money you're going to make me later.
And that's
it's perfect.
What's happening?
I'm skipping to the outro. You ready?
Uh-oh. I'm ready.
See if it plays.
Matt, money.
Matt, love having you on the show. Scott, thanks for being on the show with us. Because it's our show, not just mine. So you get mad when I say
that. Yeah, are you now the co-host?
What happened?
Oh, sorry.
No, actually, that's a better song. You think that's a better outro?
No. I like our outro. I just thought I'd throw that in there.
We'd like to get people's opinion on the new picture. Laura took it. Aaron edited it. It's a great picture of Scott and I, the wives, put together. So we'd like your input on that. And if you'd like to have it on a t-shirt, let us know too. We might make some for you. All right, let's go.
1995.
Fighter. Next week. Micro Macro.
Drop the zero. Drop the zero.org. Brought to you by Mike.